All right, well, the anti-aging business is a multi-billion dollar gold mine. Women lured into buying hope in a bottle, and men. Creams and injections that promise to make them look younger. But now scientists say they've made a breakthrough in the search for a fountain of youth. Researchers in London have extended the lifespan of mice and reduced age-related diseases. Dr. Evelyn Minaya is a gynecologist with the Riverview Medical Center, and she joins us now. Hi, doctor.
Hi, how are you, Patty Ann?
So it's already been shown that a drastically reduced daily calorie intake can make you live longer by changing your body chemistry, and now they've been able to replicate those chemical changes in mice through genetic mutation. Is that right?
Yes, it is. And remember, we already have actually an actual drug that works the same way, and what it does is that it manipulates a little bit the protein that's already inside of your body, and that's in the form of metformin. Now, if you remember, metformin is actually given to people that have insulin resistance, which, by the way, is genetic. So, you know what? Suzanne Summers and Ponce de Leon, you were all wrong. The fountain of youth is not actually found in a bottle, or is it a fountain or anything else like that. It is actually inherited, as we've known for a long, long time.
But they can possibly be able to replicate these results that they got in mice. How far might we be from trying this on people?
Yeah, that's a very, very good question. Hopefully, we will be able to focus on this, because remember, if we do not reduce our caloric intake, it does lead into obesity and then, of course, high blood pressure and diabetes. Remember, this study doesn't really pertain to how you look. It's rather than the quality of your life as you age. So it is a very, very important thing that we do work on it. Hopefully, in the next 2 to 3 years, like I said, metformin has been around for a couple of years already. We'll be able to, you know, present some more interesting medications out there.
But how complicated might it be, and what would be the potential side effects?
Well, that's just it. We didn't talk about side effects. And remember, in this study, only women benefited from this. So that was the other thing, too. So we have to now do a little bit and expand to human studies and then see if we can actually get them to do it for men and women.
Yeah, on this calorie-restricted diet does extend life, but the people who are on it say they're always hungry. And does this new method, though, potentially improve the quality as well as the quantity of life?
Yes, it does. As a matter of fact, in these mice, it was very interesting because I was like, yay, I can eat anything that I want to and then still, you know, enjoy and not gain weight or anything else like that. I think that that's why we fail in most diets, just long-term. We don't have a good long-term thing. And I think that this is the focus of this genetic study, is that the long-term effect of you dropping your weight and reducing your caloric intake without feeling hungry all the time, so you won't put all that stuff back into your system again. And I think that, like I said, your life expectancy, obviously, with the quality of life, that's the most important thing, we will also benefit.
Yeah. All right. Dr. Evelyn Minaya, thanks.
Oh, you